For the kids, all right, look. Boston Bruins, they're on their way to the sixth loss. This can't be. You cannot let a guy walk out of his end like that. You cannot change all of it. Watch, Carrick walks around. Watch them pull. Look at they pull. He has walk out there. Look at this. That's ridiculous. You gotta have a guy in there check that first guy. Ridiculous. Anyhow, all right, let's go.
Bright side, they look good coming into the rink today, the Bruins.
They did. Hey, watch the NHL guys walk in, first of all. There goes Chara. And it, there, look at that there. Any beautiful looking guy. Who's that?
I don't know. I didn't see. Bernier.
That's Bernier. Look at that nice jacket. Anyhow, they all
watching the rabbit, to tell you the truth. It's going to die here in a minute.
Hey, be careful. All right, here's the OHL guys walking in, dressed the same. Respect for the game, respect for yourselves. You should see the basketball players in, a bunch of scrubs. The moms kiss goodbye. That's the way it be. Here's Forget. I call him Forget. Gets a good goal, gets two goals, way to go. Nice little goal here. Here's Fournier. And here we have the winning goal coming in. I know, but I'm telling you, it was in. See what's right there? It was in. We blew the whistle, and I feel bad. But I did something here that I, there I am right there with David Branch and everybody getting the winning goal for it and got two goals. But here's something I did I don't think I'll ever do. It's a great pitcher, don't get me wrong. That's the Marlies in the back and York Simcoe in there. I will never do that again because it was, that's me squeezing the thing. They didn't want to take their helmets off. It's a great pitcher, but I thought it was a good idea, don't you?
Well, you know why? It was such a funny goal that ended the game. As you say, the whistle had gone, but it was a great goal. Refs were great, and York Simcoe Express were great, and the OHL Cup was great.
Ooh, was that fantastic?
Fantastic. And great ratings. So RJ Broadhead, Sam Casentino, and Jeff
Merrick. John Moore's happy.
Yes, we're all happy. Hey, listen, Don, this is great. Dan Murphy will be the anchor of Rogers Hometown Hockey at Vancouver tomorrow night when we're on the air with the Canucks and the Hawks. And he had great interviews all week, especially this one for you, though. A little surprise here. Luke Wilson.
I know I can't let you go because you want to say hi to someone first.
Yeah, you know, growing up in LaSalle, huge ordeal listening to Don Cherry talk about some good Canadian kids. So there's a few of us in the football world now, too. Just want to say hello.
His first touchdown, Don, was against San Francisco 49ers. In his rookie year, he won the Super Bowl. Unbelievable, Luke. And he's from down Windsor.
Yeah, he knows talent, LaSalle. Too. Eh?
He does know talent. I loved Scotty Upshaw interview, Dan, last night, too.
By the way, that guy's singing. That
Brett thing. Kissel.
Holy smokes. Where are you from, Calgary?
Yeah.
No, Flat River.
Flat Lake.
Flat Lake.
That's right.
Anyhow, I thought he was terrific.
And a good hockey player, yeah. Too. Speaking of great hockey, well, Len Barry has a golf course, Bear Mountain out in Victoria, and this looks like Tiger Woods. This is really something. His son, Tyson Barry.
Now, watch this here. Bobby Orr, when nobody was around, he used to do this stuff all the time, and he'd do magic, but he wouldn't do it if somebody was watching. He'd think showing up, but he could do the same thing. Now watch Tyson after get you kids, you should do that. You get the feel of the puck. See that? Now watch, he zings her home, he's got the feel. And that's it, kids. You can't be that good, but let me tell you what Bobby used to do. He used to take the puck and he used to carve in the inside out and put lead in it. So when you shoot it, and before a game, I must talk about the stuff he used to do. He used to have a stick, he'd have about five pucks taped on, he used to walk up and down like that. He was the first guy I ever saw that could just touch a puck and give it to the linesman like that. Then everybody started to do it, and they started to show off, so he stopped.
Hey, and Bobby has an idea about hockey, but we won't get into that tonight. We'll get into that next week.
Next week, Bobby, I'm going to say what you... Anyhow, we're going to...
Poor Tyson Barry. No luck today against a goalie we'll show in a second. But first goal is done. Nothing like the first one, and you got a bunch of them.
I got a bunch of them. Watch these here go in. Boy, they are fantastic. We got... It is unbelievable. Look at there. Brenston Manning from Prince George, B.C., Zach Hyman from Toronto, he puts it in. You think he's happy or what? Connor Brown, one of the best. Watch this. Ryan Pulock. Here comes Connor Brown. What a little guy he's going to be. He's going to score a lot of goals. Look at him, that beautiful. And Nick Ritchie, of course, my favorite. Way to go, Nick, boy. A monster. He is a monster. I'll tell you that. And here we have Anthony Mantha. And don't forget that Andre Provo. I remember him, Andre Provo. And the Montreal, those great teams, he was a good little checker, good the third and fourth line.
He discovered him? Yeah. Okay, Devin Dubnyk.
All right, now, no, hold it. Now, you know, I always like to put guys that are down and out, because I was down and out, but I never ever got up. But I was down and out, and I love guys when they come up. Devin Dubnyk, if you can believe it, he took all the heat when he was in Edmonton, the first round pick and everything. And let's just watch this here. It is unbelievable, this guy, to me. He went to Kamloops. He played junior in Kamloops. He went to Edmonton. He played in the ECHL. He played 3 years in the American Hockey League, and they thought he was down and out. And he went to Montreal. They got rid of him. Nashville got rid of him. Arizona got rid of him. And Don Malone, Fletcher. Fletcher got him.
Chuck, you got
and
him.
For a third-round pick. And since he's come to Mini, he's won two-thirds of his games, if you can believe it. He is a guy, and I love to see a guy that was down and out. He was saying, kids, never quit. No matter how down and out you are, you might come back like Devin.
By the way, won today with a shutout again against Colorado, and that just about cinches Wild will make the playoffs. And finally, Rob Ford, Don, I think all of us, you know, that was a tough story.
46 years old, yeah. And I wore this here when he got the, I won't go into left wing kooks and all that, but there he is there. He was the best for that year there. He was a comp for the common guy like us. He was a great guy. He was a good coach for the football team, too. Yeah. He raised the money for them, got in trouble. But anyhow, he loved all the kids, and he was an inner-city kid. And we give condolences to his family, Doug, and everything. He was a great guy and one of my friends.